Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. And this is the day where you have a technically an AI agent sitting with you and doing stuff. Okay, so I'm going to show you a complete demo of how you can use Gemini live, right? Like it's a like a streaming real-time AI agent which you can talk to right now. So let's get started, right? Without further ado, let's get started very quickly. So I want to click on talk to Gemini. And
okay, I hear an audio recording that has the word "and" said twice. Is there anything else you would like to discuss?
Okay, can you hear me saying what I am talking about? I am recording a video and I want to talk to you about what are the best steps to record a video about YouTube tutorials on technology.
Yes, I can hear you clearly. You're asking about the best steps to record a video for YouTube tutorials on technology. Is that correct?
Yes, that's absolutely correct. So again, my content is completely around technical stuff, right? And it's nothing about anything other than like, you know, just teaching people how to use AI and how do I make them engaging and also like get crazy views.
So you create technical content focused on teaching people how to use AI, and you're looking for ways to make your videos engaging and get more views. What specific aspects of video creation are you most interested in right now?
Now, again, this is not super interesting, right? Again, I'm just talking to it and that's already possible. But here's where it gets interesting, right? Let me select a video source and I want to select whole screen, right? So if I show you my whole screen, again, it will get problematic. But let's say I just select this. You can see my screen, right?
Okay, it looks like you're talking about screen recording and you're showing your screen. Are you looking for tips on how to record your screen effectively?
No, I'm good. I just want to show you my screen and talk about some stuff that I want to research about.
Understood. So you want to show me your screen and talk about some things you're researching. Go ahead. I'm ready when you are. Okay, I see your screen now. You're on a website called perplexity.ai, and there's a search bar with the text, "What is the best way to learn?" What are you researching here?
Okay, just to give you guys context, again, I have switched screens and it becomes pretty confusing because I'm talking and recording with the mic. And also I have to give it access to the mic. But here is like, you know, what I'm researching, right? And I want to research what's the best way to learn. So let's switch back Gemini on and show it. So I'm researching about like, you know, what's the best way to learn, right? For a college student. And I want your inputs on like, you know, what can I research more about this?
Okay, I see you've searched "What is the best way to learn for a college student?" on perplexity.ai. The results are showing some sources. And an answer that says that to effectively learn as a college student, it's crucial to adopt a variety of study techniques. Then it lists techniques like active recall and spaced practice. It seems like you're trying to research effective study methods for college students. Is that correct?
That's absolutely correct. But I want your thoughts on what are the other steps I can take on researching this. Maybe some documentation I can refer and some books I can read. What would you suggest me?
Okay. You're looking for additional research steps, documentation, and books to help you learn more about effective study techniques for college students. I suggest starting by looking at the sources provided by perplexity.ai. Specifically, you might explore the articles on 10 effective study tips and techniques to try this year and how to study effectively college tips. You could also search for scholarly articles or meta-analyses on educational psychology databases like ERIC or JSTOR. To dig deeper into specific study methods. For books, you can explore titles like Make It Stick by Brown, Roediger, and McDaniel, which discusses various evidence-based learning techniques.
Now again, I just replied to it with saying thanks and then like, you know, pretty much like closing the stream here. It still has access to my screen, so I can just go ahead and switch this off, right? And it's super cool that we can share something and talk about, right? But we can go a step deeper and actually use it with a mobile phone. And let me show you how does that look. Okay, so this is an example of what I was doing with Gemini yesterday through my phone. And I was showing it around my desk and everything. And I wanted to like, you know, ask it questions. How can I arrange my desk better? It was pretty messy at that time. I also talked to questions about books. And that's pretty cool. Let me play and mute myself.
See that the book's authors are Akina, Sirohi, and Varun Maya. It appears to be a guide for creating content.
Okay, perfect. Okay, so this is my desk setup, right? That you would like me to improve.
Okay, I can see your desk setup. I see a monitor, keyboard, mouse, a book, a webcam, and a ring light. Are there two specific things that you would like me to suggest improvements on?
No, there's nothing specific. Just I want it to be a bit more, I don't know, more productive. I have a lot of like problem. Like I don't have a lot of space here, right? So when I have to write, I'll either move my keyboard or do something else.
It sounds like you would like to improve the productivity of your desk setup, and you feel that a lack of space is hindering that. You mentioned having to move your keyboard when you write. Is there anything else you do at the desk besides writing that feels like it could be improved?
No, that works. Again, I also have a side table if you...
Okay, so this is super interesting. Like, again, just the stuff that you can talk to it about, right? It's literally like having an AI assistant working with you all the time. And that's the beauty of it, right? Like, you can try to do it so many stuff, right? I want to show a more complex example where I want to test how it works. I'm just going to share my screen and you can see a MailJet document open. I'm just trying to understand this API. So what I would do is very specifically select this particular window that I want to, and then just let it run. Can you explain me how to use this API?
According to the documentation, to send a basic email using this API, you need to create a JSON array called messages. Each message object in the array should include information about the sender, recipients, and email content. The sender object needs to have a name and email. Recipients should be an array of objects with the name and email of each recipient. Finally, at least one of text part or HTML part must be included for the body of the email. A template ID can also be used to send emails based on stored templates.
Can you also explain to me what is a curl request and how can I use this and where can I test it also?
Certainly. A curl request is a command line tool used to transfer data with URLs, commonly used for interacting with APIs. In this case, the curl request is sending data to the API endpoint to send an email, including all the required fields we talked about before. To test this curl command, you can use your terminal. Just make sure to replace the API key placeholders, shown in lines 2 and 3, with your actual API keys. You have those handy?
Yes, I'm good to go. Now, very simply, if you see, like, this is such a super cool thing, right? Again, you can actually have an AI assistant looking at what you're doing, talking to it and everything, and, like, you know, discussing literally anything. I was going to stop recording this, but I also, like, you know, give it as an option, like, as a system instruction, act as a expert engineer. Because, again, giving the instructions makes it just a bit better and just does not keep it iterating. Okay, is this what you're trying to do? Is this what you're trying to do? And it actually goes ahead and does stuff. And you can go more detailed in the system instructions, like, you know, how you want it to answer. Do you want short answers, long answers, whatever. And it's super cool, right? Let's just show you a couple more features on the end. If I just, like, you know, reset this, you can also see there are, like, you know, options here at the right where you can see specifically there are options to change the model, which is not available right now, obviously. But, like, you know, again, output format can be audio or text. Obviously, we need audio. Voice, you can change a couple of voice, we can give it more options to work with. But again, like, you know, just overall, it's like a super, super cool thing. So again, I would just say like this, I just want to conclude this particular video with this part. The future is already here. We are just waiting for things to come up, just engineering to match with the kind of technology that exists, right? This is nothing like crazy, right? Like, it's like a multimodal model, which has been there for a year now. But the engineering is, like, you know, marrying these things together to make into these amazing tools. So if you're someone who loves to build, here is the best thing that you can do. Subscribe to me and also learn stuff. Because the more you learn, the more you are able to do cool stuff and build something like this. I would love to see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.